Hey guys, how's it going? It's Infernoment again. Welcome back to another video, and this time I wanted to start a series where I take popular shows and give the main characters a Pokemon team. To kick off this series, I wanted to use my favorite anime and newest obsession, JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. I will be making a team for Jonathan, Joseph, Jotaro, Josuke, and Giorno. This video is the opposite of a video on my friend Random Rabu's channel, link in the description, where he made teams for every JoJo villain. The only reason I won't go past part 5 is because most JoJo fans haven't read the manga, and I've only experienced parts 1 through 5, and I will only be using localized names for the sake of those who watch the anime dubbed as I do. Just a fair warning, some of these Pokemon are spoilers for the plot of JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, so if you haven't watched the show yet and plan to, make sure you watch it before you watch this video. With that out of the way, I want to explain a couple rules I gave to myself before planning these teams. The first rule was to make sure that every JoJo had a full team of 6. I want to represent each character to the fullest, so giving them 2 Pokemon is not enough. The next rule is to not use too many Pokemon based off of appearance. Saying that a certain Pokemon looks like a character is just an opinion, and I wanted my teams to be as accurate to the character's personalities and features as possible. Finally, only 1 legendary is allowed per team, but mythicals do not count as long as they have nothing to do with appearance. Now, without further ado, here are my teams for every JoJo in JoJo's Bizarre Adventure Parts 1 through 5. If you watch JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, then the multiple JoJo plotline isn't confusing at all. But if you haven't, it might look strange without context. A JoJo is a relative of Jonathan Joestar, the first JoJo who is either Hamon user or a Stand user. Their name either has to have the sound Joe in their first name and their last name. Since Jonathan is the first JoJo, I will be doing his team first. The first Pokemon I put on Jonathan's team is Cubone. Jonathan lost his mother at a very young age after the carriage carrying the Joestars ended up crashing, killing his mother and injuring him and his father, George. Not much is revealed about his mother other than the fact that she obtained a stone mask that gives others vampiric abilities. Cubone is famous for losing its mother as a child and wearing its mother's skull as a mask, which is a perfect connection to Jonathan's backstory. The next Pokemon I added to Jonathan's team is Zongoose. Growing up a fan of Harry Potter, I associate snakes with evil and dark magic after the Slytherin house and Voldemort snake Nagini. If I were creating Dio's team, I would give him a Seviper because of its rivalry with Zongoose, being a perfect fit for Jonathan's team as Jonathan and Dio are sworn enemies who would love nothing more than stopping the other. The next Pokemon I gave to Jonathan was Arcanine. Jonathan is remembered in Part 1 for wanting to become a refined gentleman. The trainer class I think of using Arcanine the most is Generation 1's Gentleman class, and for that reason I believe Jonathan should have one, which also fits with the Joestar Mansion Fire. The next Pokemon on Jonathan's team is Lucario, because Lucario's power to turn his aura into power reminds me of Hamon. Hamon is a power obtained by Jonathan that charges electric-like energy contained by Hamon breathing that was taught to him by William Zeppeli, and he uses it to fight Dio and other vampires and zombies along the way. Lucario's Force Palm attack in Super Smash Bros. Reminds me of this. The fifth Pokemon I gave to Jonathan is Buzzable, who is only on his team for appearance. JoJo's in Parts 1 through 3 are known for being extremely buff for unknown reasons, and Buzzwole is the perfect representation for this. Ultra Beasts aren't really considered legendaries or mythicals, so that's why Buzzwole still counts. The final Pokemon on Jonathan's team is legendary Pokemon Keldeo. Keldeo is the fourth member in the legendary Swords of Justice, and Jonathan's main ambition is getting justice by defeating Dio and saving the world from the power of the Stone Mask. Since Keldeo is the Swords of Justice member with its own movie, I think it's the perfect fit for Jonathan's team. The next JoJo in the Joestar family bloodline is Joseph Joestar, grandson of Jonathan and Arena Joestar and the son of Elizabeth and George Joestar II. Joseph's team will be a bit different because he is seen in 3 different parts, aging in each one, so he does not have a full team right away. For young Joseph, I gave the cheeky Joestar Abra, a Pokemon who is famous for running away from battles as an homage to the Joestar family secret technique. Joseph is known for having a very short temper and being easily annoyed with certain tasks, so the next team member on Joseph's team is Primeape, who is known for having an ill temper and always being angry. The next member on Joseph's team is Gengar. Gengar is famous for being a ghost with a good sense of humor, who loves pulling pranks on humans and Pokemon alike. Its Ruby and Sapphire dex entry reads, "Sometimes on a dark night, your shadow thrown by a streetlight will suddenly and startlingly overtake you. It is actually a Gengar running past you, pretending to be your shadow." Joseph is definitely the goofiest Joestar, cracking jokes, predicting what a person will say next before defeating them, and even peeking through the door at a nude Lisa Lisa, who turns out to be his mom, but let's just pretend that didn't happen. Nice! Last Pokemon on young Joseph's team is Greninja, who is the only Pokemon on his team that is based off of appearance. Joseph's Hamon partner in Part 2 is the grandson of William Zeppeli, Caesar Zeppeli, who uses bubbles filled with hamon to attack foes. Caesar wears a signature scarf in which he gives to Joseph before dying a sad death to Wamu. Joseph then wears the scarf as a headband as a tribute to his lost friend, so I gave Greninja, a water-type Pokemon that uses its long tongue as a scarf, a spot on Joseph's team. When Joseph gets older in Part 3, he becomes a grandfather and a father who travels with the Stardust Crusaders to defeat Dio, who has been resurrected, using Jonathan's body as his own. Joseph finds out that he has gained a stand, its localized name being Hermit Purple, which has the ability to use cameras and television sets to find the locations of certain enemies by attaching itself to it. Since Joseph has this new ability that would certainly find itself among the ranks of mind reading, his Abra evolves into Kadabra, and finally Alakazam, who can read minds of other trainers and Pokemon. The first Pokemon old Joseph obtains is Ferrothorn as a reference to Hermit Purple, which has the appearance of thorny vines. Most people use Tangela for this reference on their teams, but Ferrothorn has actual thorns, so I chose a different path. The final team member on Joseph's team is Kangaskhan, as a reference to how Joseph is not only traveling to stop Dio and save the world, but to save his daughter Hallyakujo, whose stand is too strong for her to handle and makes her very sick. Kangaskhan is known as the parent Pokemon, and will protect its baby Kangaskhan at all costs, making it perfect for Joseph's team. The next JoJo in the Joestar family bloodline is Jotaro Kujo, grandson of Joseph and Suzy Q Joestar, and son of Hallyakujo, his father being absent and unnamed. When Jotaro's mother falls ill after Joseph warns Jotaro of Dio's return, he has no other choice than to travel to Egypt with his grandfather and other allies to use his stand and defeat Dio once and for all. Jotaro having arguably the most well-known stand, Star Platinum, I gave Jotaro the most overused Pokemon reference to his stand, Machamp, because who else could represent Star Platinum? When Jotaro's stand uses its famous Aura Aura attack, it throws multiple punches, making it appear as if it has more than two arms. The next Pokemon I gave to Jotaro is Pangoro, a Pokemon that always acts tough and is hardly seen smiling, just like Jotaro. Jotaro also usually is seen smoking a cigarette, similar to how Pangoro usually has a bamboo twig in its mouth. Pangoro's fur is also similar to Jotaro's school uniform, being the Pokemon on his team that is based off of appearance. The next Pokemon I give to Jotaro is Pyroar, which I'd say for complicated reasons. While creating Jotaro's team, I wanted to make a certain reference to metal because of the name Star Platinum, but found out that platinum is considered a noble metal because of its durability and heat. After finding this out, I decided to put a Pokemon on his team that can use the move Noble Roar, and Pyroar seemed like the best fit. Up next, I gave Jotaro Starmie because of Jotaro's degree in marine biology, which he obtained by writing a thesis on starfish. Staryu and Starmie are the only starfish Pokemon to date, so Starmie would go best on his team. Next, Jotaro is the first to obtain a mythical Pokemon, this one being Celebi. While having his epic battle with Dio in Egypt, Jotaro realizes his Star Platinum has the ability to stop time just like Dio's stand, the world. Since Celebi has the ability to travel through time, it seems like a good fit for Jotaro's team. The final Pokemon I give to Jotaro is Giratina. I hear you guys asking me why I used Giratina instead of Dialga, who represents time, and the answer is simple. Dialga is the legendary for Pokemon Diamond, and Giratina is a legendary for Platinum. Another reason is since Celebi is already on his team, another Pokemon should have a spot on his team, and that Pokemon is Giratina. The next JoJo is Josuke Higashikata. The result of an affair between Joseph Joestar and Tomoko Higashikata. Funny how Joseph can forgive the Japanese that quickly.
I'll never forgive the Japanese!
Jotaro is sent by the Speedwagon Foundation to visit a town called Morio, where Joseph's affair happened and his son Josuke lives. Morio is a seemingly normal Japanese town that has a dark secret concerning a child murder and a bow and arrow that creates stand users. Josuke gains two friends along the way, Koichi and Yokoyasu, who are both committed to stopping the murderer and obtaining the bow and arrow to prevent it from being used for evil. Josuke was probably the second hardest team to make, considering his stand's abilities aren't represented by many Pokemon, unlike his nephew Jotaro. Fortunately, one of his stand, Crazy Diamond's abilities is to heal other people by punching them. Because of this ability, I decided to use the mascot of Pokemon Healing, Chansey, who is seen in the Pokemon anime accompanying Nurse Joy in the Pokemon Center. The next Pokemon I give to Josuke is Greedent. Greedent is known in Sword and Shield for attacking trainers from trees when they shake a tree for berries, and if you defeat or run away from Greedent, it steals some of your berries. One specific reason this Pokemon belongs on Josuke's team is because of the two episodes where Okoyasu and Josuke meet an 8th grader named Shigechi, who has a stand that can pick up small lost items that most people can't find or notice. When they send his stand to get lottery tickets, they end up with one that was thrown away with a 5 million yen prize. Josuke and Okuyasu refuse to let Shigechi go without their fair share of the prize, representing greed. The next spot on Josuke's team would go to Beedrill, a Pokemon famous in the anime for chasing Ash and the gang from Forest. The second Part 4 intro song is titled Chase, which is told through the eyes of Josuke, who is chasing after Yoshikage Kira to avenge those he murdered. Gumshoes takes the next spot on Josuke's team because of the fur on the top of his head that seems to represent human hair. A lot of people compare this hair to Donald Trump, but I think that poking fun at this Pokemon's hair is similar to poking fun at Josuke's hair, something he most definitely does not allow. There are multiple Pokemon with weird hairstyles that could fit this slot, and Gumshoes usually stands on its hind legs and has fur that looks like a school uniform jacket, which Josuke always wears. In contrast to Jonathan's Cubone, Josuke has a Marowak because of how he lived his life, used to the fact that his father was absent, with no identity of his father until Jotaro came to Morio. I'm sure that Cubone evolves when it has accepted its mother's passing and absence, becoming its own warrior, which is why it would be great on Josuke's team. The last Pokemon I give to Josuke is Dialga. Once again, Dialga is on this team because it's the mascot of Pokemon Diamond. Shining Diamond does not have time-changing abilities like Star Platinum or the World, but it can repair broken items and heal injuries, which is kind of like turning back time. The last JoJo I made a Pokemon team for is Giorno Giovanna. Giorno was produced by Dio when Dio was still alive and had visited Japan. Since Dio had used Jonathan's body to do this act, they are both technically the father of Giorno, making Giorno a Joestar family member. Giorno was born in Japan as Haruno Shibana to his unnamed mother, who moved to Italy and married his stepfather, who is also unnamed except for his last name Giovanna. Haruno's name was changed to Giorno. One day, Giorno ends up saving a man who turned out to be a mafioso, and he grows up wanting to join the mafia and travel with other mafiosos and his stand, Golden Wind, to defeat the boss who sells drugs to children. Giorno's team was most definitely the most difficult to create because he uses his stand the least out of all the JoJo's before him, giving little to the imagination on what Pokemon he could use. However, we do know that Golden Wind has the ability to transform items into objects or body parts to replace lost body parts that may have been shot or cut off. Since he has the ability to transform things, I decided that Giorno would have Ditto, the transforming Pokemon. Ditto is not the most useful Pokemon, but would fit with Golden Wind's ability. The next Pokemon I gave to Giorno is Charizard because he ignores what Abakio tells him, similar to how Charizard originally refused to listen to Ash during battles and attack on its own. The next Pokemon I gave to Giorno is actually an idea from my friend Neo-something, who suggested Shiny Sableye as a team member for Giorno, not only for being gold, but because of the gem inside of its chest, which is a reference to Giorno being Josuke's great uncle. Alolan Dugtrio is the next Pokemon Giorno's team because of the addition of golden hair to the classic Dugtrio's appearance, similar to how Giorno's original black hair turns gold as he gets older. Since Giorno can heal his allies with his stand, I gave Giorno Jirachi, who has the move Wish, which heals other teammates or even itself in a later turn during the battle it uses the move in. The last Pokemon I gave to Giorno is Ho-Oh, which of course is because Ho-Oh is the legendary Pokemon in Pokemon Gold. Well guys, there you have it. Those are the teams I gave for every JoJo in parts 1 through 5 of JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. Let me know if you agree with any of my choices and let me know in the comments if there are any Pokemon you would swap out. Also make sure to let me know which show you want me to make teams for next. That's going to be it for this video, so make sure you like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. This is Infernum Burning Out, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Goodbye.